And that's very nice right there. Now don't run away now. But there we go. It's just moving off past us. And that's about as good a view of a giraffe as you're going to get from a bushwalk point of view. They generally don't let us get too close. And it's funny to watch giraffe because they'll watch you and they'll watch you and they'll watch you. And then you get to a certain point and they decide, nope, that's close enough. And off they'll go. But I love watching giraffe walk. It's one of my favorite things. Now, I'm not sure if all of you know what the sort of collective noun is for a group of giraffe. There is actually two. And one is for when they're moving and one is for when they are standing. So if you do know, hashtag Safari Live, let's see how many people know the difference between the two and what they're actually called as a collective noun. Now, you can see it stopped now in the beautiful light. Thank you, giraffe. That's very kind of you. And I was saying that I enjoy when they walk, and the reason why is because they use sort of both their legs on one side of the body to move, and so to be able to counteract that, you'll find that the whole neck moves, and they have this kind of body that seems completely out of sync. So the neck goes to the right while the left legs move, and then shifts to the left when the right legs move, and it all kind of balances it for, in terms of weight, but it looks so awkward as they do. So I always enjoy watching a giraffe trying to walk away from us. There we go, you can see how those legs move. Now, the reason why they do use both legs at the same time is obviously so that they don't kick themselves. Having such long legs is not the best thing when you are walking. It means that you end up, if you had to walk like any of the other antelope species, you would end up in a situation where you would actually kick yourself all the time. So they have a slightly different way of walking. Now, we're going to carry on our path and see if we can't find our giraffe in a little bit more sort of open section. So, Starlight Pan, you're wondering which animals we hide from and which ones we don't when we're on foot. Well, I suppose hide is a relative term. More like be cautious and try and use cover and to try and sort of not disturb an animal would be all your dangerous species. So, things like elephant, buffalo, lion, leopard, rhino, those are all animals that you're going to try and utilize cover, you're going to try and utilize the wind as much as possible, because those animals, if they do detect you, there is a very real risk that they could be aggressive towards you and that you could get yourself into serious harm. So you have to be a bit careful with those, and that's why we do that. Craig, just be careful of the branches here. So those are animals that we be very careful of. Hippos out of water is another one, and then you've got to be a little bit wary of the other animals that are a little bit more skittish of us. So things like wild dog, cheetah, those animals, they don't really like to see people on foot, and they're generally just going to get up and go, and so you're leaving a negative impact on them. So you try and sort of stay as hidden as possible for those animals, not because of the fact that they're going to attack you, but more for their own benefit, that you don't end up chasing them. Now,